searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never came out of news, that's what paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, question the
This is Death News.
Hey yo, yeah, I can check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19, huh? I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chats coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They like, hold up, wait a minute, like, don't make sense, don't really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that JT finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey yo, Nike check. T-shirt check. Sneakers check. Socks check. Hoodie check. Shorts check. Nike check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. The shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Get the bag and then I flip it. Watch me do it. Going stupid, trying to put them on, but they never do it. Going up sky high while I'm rocking Air Force. And she just wanna ride, shorty bad and gorgeous. She was rocking stripes, said it's alright. Then I cut her off, shorty stepped on my off whites. Okay, now wait. Gotta get the bag in racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't. I'm saying, got a new Prestos and a Jason Ray. Got a new wristwatch, but it don't take time. I fill up on a hop if it's too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. I made it about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got checks coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They like, hold up, wait a minute, like, don't make sense, don't really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep it racking my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey, hey yo. Nike check.
Well, the roof is closed, but as you can probably tell, the mouths of these Cowboy fans could not be more wide open. It is a frenzied AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Dallas Cowboys. Teams fighting for one berth in Super Bowl 55 in Tampa. Let's do it. It's NFC Championship time. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
At their own 28-yard line.
Incomplete. Got out of the pocket, didn't look. It's rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Throwing again. Wilson. They'll run the screen with Carson. He finds an opening past the 40. Seattle. Chris Carson, 72 yards. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. On this stage, conference championship game, every play is magnified, and that was a big play.
No doubt about it. One thing that has these guys a step away from a shot at a big game, their big play ability. They can strike from anywhere.
And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Seahawks 7, Cowboys nothing. Michael Dixon to kick off for Seattle.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, 75 yards. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Rick Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
They're on 20-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Brings up second and 4.
The throw here going to be complete to Gordon. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
To no avail.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Jacobs now. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Third down.
I don't let bygones be bygones, it's that's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights, nah, that's what you call a God complex.
Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man, it feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket.
Look at the flex, yeah, whipping the Teslas.
Ooh,
I'm a mess, but I'm a, it's all a finesse. Ooh. Boy, yo, stop it, quiet, if it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining, white diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot, look at me, stylish, stylish.
Masterpiece, bought it, young. Every day, you cannot run with me, but I'm everywhere. Baby, I know what's coming, I can
never a cap, out of the draft, watching me bow, soon as I snap, hit of the pack, wop for the sack, shaking a mile, breaking a mile, talking my talk, walking my wall like I do, sit on the throne, get in the zone, turn it on, maybe the shoes, maybe the team, maybe the camp, maybe the crew, you need a win, who need a win, that's all we do. I've been a king and I've been about mine. Never could doubt mine. They running the route. I leave an outline when I hit them. Drills and working the wheel where you're grinding at. You know what it be. Playing this here for the keeps. Had to make out with a feast. A family to feed. Third cold where the trophy should be. EA got me in the game now. Read on with the game now. They're hearing with a lane now. My home second with a rain now.
Well, the roof is closed, but as you can probably tell, the mouths of these Cowboy fans could not be more wide open. It is a frenzied AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl. And we've got a classic in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Dallas Cowboys.
Michael Dixon, the kickoff for Seattle.
For a chance to come back to this very stadium in 2 weeks' time, we are off and running in the NFC Championship. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. Beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
First down, Prescott. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Elliott. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 13 yards on the game's opening play. Prescott on first down. Connects here with the tight end, Blake Jarwin. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4.
Second and 4.
Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Flush to his right. And a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. He gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. Nobody ever wants the interception on the opening drive to happen, but when it happens in the playoffs, it feels like it's a bigger deal. What a rough start.
And how about these visitors? The defense just went right on the field and seized momentum. You know, almost like they're saying, okay, no one expects us to win this one. Let's go ahead and give them a shock early. Took the ball from the home team and put them in the hole.
Because this crowd, one of the best in the league, especially this time of year, it's going to be tough to take them out of it, but that's a heck of a start.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
From the 29. Wilson. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. Wilson. He'll buy some time right. He may try and run for this. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the 1st down. First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. He pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards, 2nd down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On 2nd and 7, Wilson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. Things could just not have started any better for them. They get the turnover, the football right away, able to capitalize on offense for 6.
And you're talking about setting a tone in any game, right? The first points of a ball game, how about during the playoffs? Vitally important. And they've done that in this one.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And they'll be backed up to start this drive as he's taken down right around the 15.
First and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 15. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott.
Number 21.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Jamal Adams there on the tackle. A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
Now Elliott looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage.
Carlos Dunlap.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
It's third down.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. This is Elliott. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed left for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage. They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
On third down, Elliott. And he can only get this to the 42-yard line. And that is not near enough. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And he didn't quite have the back spin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've got things going their way early. 14-0 lead and the football. First and 10. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Nothing.
They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out right. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second and 5 now. Wilson. Now they go screen. It's complete. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal. Here's Jacobs. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead.
Offensive line coaches always tell their guys, if we score touchdowns, that means we get to the end zone first. That's exactly what those blockers did, clearing the way for their back.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game because that was his longest run of this contest.
A run by Elliott, a good one on first down as he's able to pick up about six there.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Prescott from the gun on third. This to Jarwin. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. This is good for a first down, his second grab of this NFC Championship bout. 2 minutes remain in the first half of this NFC Championship. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Prescott. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. Jarrod Reed breaking through to get him to the ground. It's a loss of seven. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Eluding the pressure right. And Prescott, his third interception. Picked up by the linebacker Bobby Wagner. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. Well, this is one heck of an individual performance we're witnessing. That is now his third interception. And keep in mind, folks, this isn't a safety or a cornerback. This is a linebacker.
Does this feel to you like he's having a flashback? Because a lot of these linebackers we see in the NFL, in high school, they were offensive stars. They touched the football all the time. It's like he said to himself, let's go back.
And it's caught inside the 30. Yeah. It is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
And the Seahawks first down.
So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They will run out of the gun with Jacobs. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. It's a linebacker, Manti Te'o, on the stop.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Wilson. Seahawks moving pretty well through the air. Another first down. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. He's at the 50, 30, 20, 10. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Rick Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This is Gibson. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. Right? Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway of the NFC Championship game. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Wilson, the Seahawks take over now. First and 10 at their own 21. The ground, Jacobs will get the third quarter started. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Once again, it's Jacobs. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Josh Jacobs.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On first down, Carson. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Going to set him back 5 yards. Following the delay, here's second and 9. They run again with Carson. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the gun on 3rd down, Wilson. And it's complete into the hands of Carson. Anderson. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Well, if you're going to turn things around in a game like this, Charles, those are the kind of plays that you need.
And I just love the way that defense rallied to the football on that one. They got the completion, but he was smothered behind the line of scrimmage. And when you make tackles like that, your whole defense is going to be fired up. Really nice play getting to the ball.
51 yards on the punt there. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10.
At their own 17-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On second and 7, Prescott. We'll go underneath here to Elliott. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4.
Offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Prescott from the gun. Cooper's got it. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Ezekiel Elliott going to take it the distance.
You got to love it, baby. Give us a look.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
And this carries into the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive, first and 10. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
He was brought down by
an opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, knock the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
One quarter remains until the NFC crowns its champion. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run on first down. It's Carson. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
At the 40-yard line.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. There's Wilson. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Gain on the play. First down, Seahawks.
Throwing is Wilson. They try to set up the screen. It's complete. A good first down call as the screen play gets him nine. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a three and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
Now Wilson on first down. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on second and 15. Now it's Wilson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. They'll wind up getting 10 back there as it'll leave him with a third and five.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Here's Wilson to throw. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On first down, it's Jacobs. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover, because one more score, and this game's over.
They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Sean, 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Chris Carson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt-away-the-game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative plays, and that way you're able to run what you want to run when you get a chance to call it.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before, because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters, because you know they'll make some adjustments.
The Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
Number 47.
Prescott. He's going to let it fly. That's caught inside the 20. It's a big play there on third down. 52 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. They'll pitch it out to Elliott. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up 2nd and a yard.
To throw is Prescott. This will be caught in about the 6. And the Cowboys are going to be looking at 1st and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. The Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Prescott now. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a 1-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
So with under 30 seconds to play, this is the game right here. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
And as they take that knee, you can hear a pin drop in this stadium right now, partner.
I'd say you could hear a pin drop except for one thing. You're hearing a lot of people on cell phones right now calling and saying, cancel my reservation, because this crowd thought they were going to the Super Bowl. They had trips planned, hotels, reservations, the whole deal. That's all wiped out now.
On 2nd down, Jacobs. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game. Charles, let's focus for a second on the losing side. In a couple months, they may look back and say, wow, you know, it was a great season. But right now, I guarantee they're feeling no sugarcoating on this one.
And you can already see the T-shirts at training camp next year, can't you? Unfinished business. Because they've got to find a way to motivate these guys to go through all the same pain, right? All the same tough stuff, and find their way back and give themselves a chance to win this game again next year.
And that will do it for this one. For Charles Davis, myself, and the entire crew, we'll see you in 2 weeks at the Super Bowl.